afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting propaganda cast from your host, Imperial Dane. We're off here to a 2v2 on Trois Points with me, your host, Imperial Dane. It's not going to be Monday Novice Fight, despite this being Monday, partly due to, well, people aren't really marking the replays Monday Novice Fight, which all means when I have to look back through 30 or 40 replays, I'm not going to be able to quickly spot out the Monday Novice Fights, which actually makes a difference. Also, those that do so tend to do it, you know, might not realize, for example, 2v2's no mixed allies. I apparently have to say it a lot of times, but no mixed allies. Anyways, we have Dulix here and Chuck Norris fighting for the United States of America here for the 3rd Armored Division. We got Chuck Norris already here with Rifle Company chosen. Dulix with Airborne, Armor, and Infantry Company here going up versus Kreutz und JRMG with a surprisingly similar looking bunch of doctrines, with exceptions of Mechanized Assault and Jägerarm being what stands out at either player. But fighting here for Deutschland. Fighting for the 1st SS Panzer Division, Leibstandarte. Got a mix of infantry arriving and light machine guns here for both players. Bulletins are heavily here for armor, by the way, for Chuck. Although, nope, by the way, these two do not benefit the EC-8. Just a quick note there. Onwards infantry here, a bit of armor there. And something for the Tiger Ace, as well increasing its line of sight. We've got some aggressive moves towards here. By the way, noting the American players have in both cases rushed for the fuel point, setting up barbed wire here, wiring off some of the tombstones. But clearly there's a plan here from the Americans. Grab the fuel denied to the Krauts. We've got an ambulance here rushing ahead here for Chuck, by the way. That's definitely some high stakes play there within the first few moments. Thors is advancing up there. Got Riesland here trying to hold up the Pioneer, but there's a bit of that infantry lag. We've got more Riesland troops arriving. Though it's definitely going to be tricky for just these few not so experienced troops to try and hold back the German onslaught. And several of them are already risking here being interred. We've got the veteran rifle here moving up. Almost veteran too, by the way, already. We've got the ambulance actually moving in here. I wonder what Chuck's planning. Meanwhile, Durek's here fighting on here versus Kreutz here with an MP42 in the nearby building. Gunny's moving in as well. Durex here perhaps a bit more well armed, though his men are a bit further back as well. They've got an MP42 sitting up here at the very outskirts near some larger graves. Or more slims, I don't know what to call them. Troops are suppressing. He's actually using the medic crew to secure the victory point. Very bold there. Very bold play by Chuck. Another veteran rifle unit in the ranking. There we go, ambulance done securing, needs to get out of there before it gets turned into, well, a Zeev. We've got pioneers holding up the larger mansion. We've got Gunnadies moving up with an MB42 support. Might actually take our position there, because we actually block the area around him, particularly with a bit of barbed wire to make a direct approach difficult for Durex. We'll see, maybe some grenades. There goes, troops getting caught there. The Gunnadies, on the other hand, are quickly getting gunned down here as well, looking a bit grim. Getting a fuel point there, and there, the Germans initial, well, the Americans initial push has rather hit a snag, as German resistance in particular here was a bit more than expected. I'm not, in fact, not entirely sure what Chuck Norris was expecting with only 2 Riesland squads. They will hold against the Krauts no matter what, but they're not trained, Captain. I don't care. And he's got rather than being pushed back, troops advancing rapidly. No sign of taking up so far, though we got grenades on the way for Dukes. It's not here. Smoke up things before, say, lopping a grenade into the attic and blowing up some Krauts. Forces are going to get the MD42 here, proving now a bit more of a middle obstacle, since the Americans can really approach from certain angles. Of course, an assault up here, and in fact, an assault from several points here could actually prove dangerous. Fighting continues over here. JMG finding himself being a bit pushed back here by Chuck's men, constantly pouring in more veteran soldiers. Well, whatever written so well in the 3rd Armored, since it did suffer some rather high casualties compared to others, which probably would have meant they had a lower quantity of veterans compared to any other. The Gunners then counting and tacking. Rifle falling back. They go more recent troops. Looks like he's actually abandoning the side here. Looks like they're going double down here on Kreutz. Question is, can JRMG quickly react to this and save his comrade, who's quickly getting overwhelmed? Here's the Americans swarm in from all sides. They're like rats, Fritz! Like rats! They're everywhere! And I keep shooting. 7-Zek keeps coming more. And there go grenades flying through the windows. The MG gun, in fact, could get torn apart here for Kreutz. His men here trying desperately to hold back the enemy. And there go the MG42. There we go. Makes it up, but gets quickly cut down. Kreutz here being utterly overwhelmed. Looks like he is slowly moving in there, Mr. JRMG. Finally going to maybe assist his Kameraden. Meanwhile, though, it's a complete disaster on the left flank. The outskirts of the village have been cleared of Krauts, and we are in fact seeing also an MD42 there handed over to the armies. How can we help? We got taking up there, and already here. In fact, he's taking onwards. He's ignoring the light to make a nice company. Where CMG is bothering with that? No, so far, by the way, Duke's now also chosen Doctrine. He's chosen infantry, where's JMG, and Kreutz so far has not chosen either. Kreutz, by the way, could already now. Oh, otherwise, I'd gone for maybe encirclement and called out some stormtroopers, but we are instead seeing elite Torpen, which does open up here for stun grenades, amongst other things. Also, some Torp training. Force is trying to break through here the central road bridge. Take being a bit exposed here. An MG 42 in the nearby house, making things a bit more difficult here for the Americans to move through. An ambulance in the way for Durex. Meanwhile, looks like Chuck might try and sneak up through here. Ping's a bit more. Well, calm down, although we still got the MD42 waiting here for any armies. We've got a lot of infantry here hanging about, actually. They could all secure the pointer up there, and looks like the house here has been turned into a small fortress there with the MD42 on top. Actually, able to cover here quite nicely, though we do got a quick rub grenade there. Doing actually no damage there, just not so well aimed in that case. Nonetheless, forcing a retreat right there from Durex as we got Kaneza counterattacking. JMG launching his Kaneza. Needs to use some cover, mate. Cover in Dekon. Charge a bit too rapidly, though. He might actually be able to storm the MD42 in a small dash of luck here, but at the same time, he's leaving himself onto a grenade. And there go pineapple grenades flying through the air. Oh dear, just a horrible massacre of German soldiers. Rather reckless, you should have left some troops here to cover from this side, for example, as well, spread them up a bit more. Rather reckless there, and the MD42 was ultimately cleared up, basically meaning a waste of manpower there for JMG. Now his MD42 getting assaulted as well. Though, no, grenade it seems for Chuck, which got a lot of news to clear it out. Getting pinned there, so there's no chance of really solving them. Some troops are about to get suppressed as well. So that effort, at most, into the port neutral. We're also seeing several caches here being laid down by the Americans. Chuck building both a fuel and a munitions cache. Intriguing. Meanwhile, support armor core here up for Kreutz. His forces, though, are rather beaten, which will certainly leave JMG to so far do most of the work at the moment. Which is certainly also a bit risky here. And there we go. As the suppress here leaves up for the rifleman to then move forward to deal with the MU42. Beginning to bleed up. We got troops moving forward. Pioneers being sent to reinforce support. No checking up here, though we do got Chuck going for it. Might be an idea then for Dukes to go for, say, the lieutenant. He could add in 50 calibers. We could also, say, call in an M20 and begin laying down mines. Which would certainly help, though, and certainly also maybe slow down whatever armoured rush here Kreutz is planning. Americans are pushed out here. Successful assault here by Kreutz on JRMG. Americans are slowly creeping in. Very slowly there. Looks like Dukes is preoccupied with other matters. We've got the munitions cache going down. There's a 2 munitions cache, 1 fuel cache there for the Americans. That's definitely a lot of extra resource, in particular a lot of extra munitions going in there. And that'll certainly also help them in case they say want to upgrade for weapons. It just allowed them to call in a lot of artillery. There we go. Got some counter the light machine gun. The very outskirts of the base here now, threatened by American efforts. Quick rifle grenade there. Though we got a Granatenwerfer out here for the Germans. Deutschland. Captain here for Chuck Norris. He could add in a light tank, a pack howitzer could also work. Anti-tank gun miles would be wise. In fact, the Americans are quite, in fact, vulnerable to an early armor rush. In fact, a quick flak panzer could prove quite nicely, though they are a bit behind in fuel there. Also, JRMG has chosen mechanized assault. It would actually not be a bad idea to get, say, some assault grenades out here in these kind of quarters, but so far he's making no sign of using the doctrine whatsoever, which does make it a bit odd he then chose it. There you go, quick rifle grenade. Ah! Look, oh! Good lord, a double rifle grenade there. Well, the first one did nothing, the second one there caught the Americans completely wiping out the entire lot. Looks like also Chuck Norris has upgraded for the BAR, increasing his firepower of the men there, but that one hurt a bit. Need to put Kel Button ring about like that. Anyways, Ravnik is going up, but there we go. Might go down. Ravnik Nate's flying left and right. Jurix might have. There we go. Oh, he's still losing a Ravnik squad like that. Me getting a Storm Gestritz here for Deutschland. Nima goes here. Loafing about as well. And we got a Steward Light Tank there following up. We got another Rifle Squad here for Durex, who's still not showing any signs of taking up. Maybe he's calling for infantry. He definitely needs to sort of quickly move onwards. Again, Lieutenant would be going to the Mediguns afterwards to get the Major out for some armor there. Quick Scott or Sturm could also aid them a bit, and certainly might slow down the Sturm Gestütz just a wee bit. Since in particular, currently, Durex was actually now going to Mortar Attack. Very interestingly enough, will be vulnerable to that Sturm Gestütz. And there you go. Stu 3G mobilized. Some of JMG's forces they need to pull back. Securing the northern outskirts of the town. Well, we got Chuck here pushing back the Germans. JMG being slowly pushed away. Though, Chuck might want to consider needing some more veteran riflemen. He's actually short on infantry. Another rifleman then equipping them with dual BARs would actually do a lot, I think, to push back here. JRMD was not getting Panzer Grenadiers. He's upgrading with Panzer X already. In fact, he's getting a lot of anti-tank assets already. Stuart there rushing ahead. Needs to be careful, though. Getting a bit too close. They're already coming under fire from the Pack 40. Not another Pack 40 here. He actually had two Pack 40s, and he's getting Panzer Grenadiers with Panzer X. I rather think here JRMG is ignoring a little fact, which is you also need to kill the infantry. He's going a bit too heavily there towards anti-tank. Though it rather did, in this case, result in the Stuart there. Clearly, Chuck was not expecting that. Meanwhile, we've got Sturm Gestütz here running forwards. I'll spread out your men, Kreutz. Spread out your men. Get out for the fleets. They're getting equipped there. Sturm Gestütz running forwards. Opening up there in the mortar half-track. Nasty vehicle loss there for Durex. Right near stop by that MG42 continually there. He could actually call down white phosphorus now on it, which might actually will help a future assault on this position. Durex, on the other hand, who's also got plenty of munitions, might want to consider beginning upgrading his men there with the Browning Luck machine guns, which are also unlocked for him, which certainly do quite a bit of good there versus the infantry, though, of course, not so much versus the Sturm Gestütz.
The enemy is taking our territory.
More grenadiers, more MG42s there on the way. Immer mehr Infanterie. Pentamount machine gun on the Stuk could maybe be an idea. Ravnir getting mortared. And there we go, we got Brownings being handed out here, and I think he's... Yes, indeed, he's dual equipping them. Forming some very heavy firepower units there for his men there, which will certainly do a lot to pressure Kreutz up here, although of course this dude can still largely shrug it off. Where the bazooka's on that. He's also gone for captain here. I'm getting away to figure this. Maybe again, some M20 mines here and there could sort of slow down a further armored assault in particular, because the Germans so far here, you know, have got no mines at all. So, I mean, a quick that could easily slow down anything that might arrive there from the Germans. And again, the Panzer Grenadiers. Rather limited action use here for JRMG. Again, I have no idea why he went for it when he only had two pack 40s out. Seems like in this regard, JRMG is a bit playing not according to what's happening on the battlefield, but according to a plan in his head, and he's not adapting it to what the hell's going on, actually. Stuk here finding this one, gonna be sort of being a bit of trouble there. Stuk moving forward, he's trying to get the ambulance. It's a bit risky then. There we go, though. Ambulance knocked out. Ambulances, unsurprisingly, not very durable versus 75mm. Cannon. Then he's falling back with that machine gun. Stuk, they're getting off some good shots. They're killing Americans left and right. Painted my machine gun. They're also getting off some kills. Oh, there we go. Nice shooting, Jesus. Thank you. I learned that on the Eastern Front.
Orders.
Got forces breaking through there. And we got here again the problem here a bit with the JRMG. His forces are not really well meant for fighting the infantry of Chuck Norris, in particular with the BARs and our flamethrowers. In that case, you got a woman. In fact, there's a MG42 now securable. And he's getting more Panzer Shreks. Come on, JRMG. Get your head into the fight. You also got a sniper here, actually, for Kreutz. Captain in a bit of trouble. But the Germans are being pushed back here slowly. Very slowly. And in the case of the JRMG, I mean, it's much clearer what the cause is, and that again, that's basically because he does not quite seem to be playing fully according to what's happening on the battlefield. Instead, that tiny plan in the head, which ignores reality, which is always something you have to be careful with, which is rather leaving him vulnerable here to Chuck Norris's infantry, which are actually quite handsomely equipped. We also got a support McCoy, in fact, up for JRMG as well. Interesting enough, he's so far made no use of the Doctrine at all. Normally, at least see them go for the Stugi, but he's not even doing that, so I'm very curious as to what the hell he's thinking, because it doesn't strike me as being very rational. We got a Panzer Force to support the Sturmgeschütz here for Kreutz. Securing points here, we got the Sniper creeping around. He could actually pop an into a building. I think this one would allow him good coverage of the surrounding area, also increased line of sight, of course, that way being able to take advantage of the range better. Dukes, they're counter-attacking. He's also got bazookas upgraded. Though he doesn't seem to be making use of them. I mean, he should. I mean, in that case, he's got plenty of munitions. Upgrade the rear strong troops with bazookas. I mean, that's always how I do it. You know, grab some bazookas on the rear strong troops, form an anti-tank team that way. There goes Sturmgeschütz supporting Panzer IV moving up there. He could stand to move the Sturmgeschütz a bit further forward. There's no reason to hold it that far back. We got Dukes' infantry here marching forwards. And there you go, quickly taking losses to the Panzer IV, freshly arrived on the battlefield. And we've got Chuck Norris attacking it from another angle, quickly applying serious pressure here to Kreutz's forces. Stuke doing what they can to fight, covering fire, they're having a bit of a hard time, they're hitting. Mortar rounds going down, so we've got the captain moving up. Gunning off some shots there, one shot, they're failing to penetrate, more mortar rounds going down, captain taking heavy losses, doing good shots, gaining off several kills there. More captains arriving. Surprisingly, he's not trying to use the building, which would make it easier for them to survive and harder for the tank to kill them. Stug on the other hand should not be moving so close there. Bit of a silly move there by Kreutz. And again, moving out into the streets instead of into the building right there. I definitely feel that was a tactical mistake right there by Dukes. But actually, it's time for the mid-game analysis. Current situation is the Germans under oppression. In some regards, they're still striking back here. The Americans themselves have left a few significant strategic gaps in their lines, although we do now see one of them being plucked here with the arrival of the first Sherman EC-8 here by Chuck Norris. 50 caliber already there on top on the way. So that's a nice start, but Dukes there getting an anti-tank and also help, but overall I think though he needs to take up, he needs to go for some moment out. Or he could consider, you know, getting a priest out, that way bombarding some of the German lines, in particular to help here, I think, versus JRMG, who's much more reliant on support weapons and positions. That way he could soften him up for Chuck Norris as an example. So that would be something there to consider for Dukes, but otherwise take up for some armor. In fact, he's floating a bit of resources there. And again, reinforce these chaps, get some bazookas on them, get them out. I mean, there's no reason to research bazookas if you're not going to use them. In fact, he could easily afford a second team and equip them with bazookas as well. That way he could actually create a sort of mobile light team, in particular in these, with all these buildings run, quickly pop them up, say when there's tanks, flanks exposed to it, and give them a good broadside. In fact, that could actually do quite reasonably well here versus the medium tanks so far available here from the Reich. So that would certainly be something to consider there. And Chuck Norris might also want to use occasionally his white phosphorus bad ideas to break up some of the enemy's defenses as well. And again, a part of me would also like to see one of them tank back and consider getting an M20 out to sort of mine vital spots. That would also do them quite a bit of good. Though so far, I mean, interesting enough, the Germans make very little use of the Doctrines, which I suppose could to a certain extent highlight the fact either of them is likely going to get a tiger, in which case, of course, the M20 mines would be absolutely brilliant. I mean, in particular, the Tiger Ace would suffer hugely from being utterly mobilized all of a sudden in the middle of the village. But again, for Dukes, tech up. For Chuck Norris, tech down. Get the lieutenant, get some M20s out, and again, Dukes, tech up. Get some Jacksons, get some Shermans to cover for them. I think that would overall do well for them. For the Germans, JRMG needs to get his act together. I mean, he really seems to be one basically dragging down the German efforts here. He's again playing according to some plan in his head, which is always something you should not do. So in that regard, he's definitely not doing too well. But he should upgrade his grenadiers as much as possible. I mean, he could soon get a Tiger, but overall, get out of Panzer IV initially, I think would help to sort of support his infantry better. Maybe some mines, get some caches up, get those grenadiers upgraded with light machine guns. I mean, upgrade, upgrade, upgrade. Get some Panzer out, push forwards, and maybe mine some points here and there. Maybe some S minefields will do a lot to slow down the Allies that way. Quite on the other hand, handling things better, he could consider maybe using some stun grenades here and there to sort of deal with the American defenders and attackers. Can actually do a lot there in that regard. Maybe he should actually consider pulling back his Stug and then use troop training. I mean, it's actually a very good ability in that way, you know. You get a bit of experience for your armor, say first level, then you move that quickly, move up to veteran 2 where they suddenly get the armor bonus. I mean, that's definitely one way of doing it. I could certainly also consider it with the Panzer IV. I mean, overall, getting this back, use troop training would actually do a lot, I think, for Kreutz. Starting to give him some harder armor to deal with here for the Americans, and would definitely, I think, be a huge boost to them. But he's overall the one sort of handling things a bit more wisely, to be honest. So there's less criticism there for him. Again, it's largely on JRMD, who, again, I mean, particularly also this being about like a large anti-tank team, not so wise either, would leave them separated from this and also vulnerable to infantry. I mean, keep them supporting, keep them intermixed. But again, overall, don't just equip all your Panzer, because with Panzer Strikes might well, 10 minutes before anything actually happens with them. I mean, again, it's not good. But back here to the fight. Large action again. In most cases, it seems like the Allies do like to sort of gang up here and pull Kreutz, and he's certainly also the more threatening of the two, so you can certainly understand it. CZ8 there being a bit quickly flanked down by the Panzer IV, and we got artillery going down here from Durex. Again, I think he should have expended in Bazooka. Looks like one captain here got his life, will rapidly wiped out. Artillery doesn't do too much. We got a rifle squad here flanking up with a flamethrower, only tying themselves up here in front of the Panzer IV and the Sturm Geschütz, high explosive shells and machine gun bullets, raking them down. They also got the Granaten there for actually close to veterans, T3. And he got his EC8. They actually did a bit of damage to the Panzer gun. This actually caused JMG to quickly pull back, despite probably having a chance of knocking it out. But he needs that EC8 repaired, and I imagine he's going to get more of them. I mean, that's matching wise. He went for that extra fuel cache. MG42, there seems to have been knocked out after being pilfered from the Germans. Same one here. Chuck Norris needs to be a bit careful. And Durex, is he taking up? Oh, finally, praise the heavens. Anti-tank gun there, forced to fall back. Got the rifle moving up with lots of Brownings. The Stug here is slightly blasting away at some rear slants up north. Getting back the fuel point there. We got Kreutz here, properly spreading out his men, not just lobbing away or holding away, also trying to use a bit of cover here and there. We got Gross! Rifle grenades, again, stun grenades could also help them here at these quarters. And we got an artillery barrage going in there from JMG. Lights his infantry, good shots. Bombarding, blasting. Not quite hitting the unit. The EC-8 far, far away getting repaired there. I think, in fact, he might have moved it a bit too far away of anything. Just a small comment there. We got the Panzer IV from JMG moving into support. Kreutz. Then it's grenaded. Panzer IV moving through the suburbs. Holy hell! I mean, be careful of clumping out your troops then. Durek certainly learned that lesson. I mean, it can be tempting to some players to just blob up when they got that many Brownings up. In this case, the mortar just took them to town. The Panzer IV, and I suppose the infantry cleared up the rest. Look, Dieters, they're all crawling around like ants. Yeah. Huge ants, though. Anyways, we've got a Tiger Ace here summoned forward to the front. From the 101st SS Schwerpanzerabteilung. Achtung! Close beam to calling in another EC in here though for Chuck Norris. Ravnir getting the pioneers, the grenadiers though. Ravnir should actually pull back here, the grenadiers could easily prove some problems, so with a flamethrower they're still doing kind of good damage. And we got the Panzer grenadiers moving in support, but again they're not really going to do much versus the infantry. We actually got the EC-8 moving forward, straight into the Panzers, getting another full volley there. Rather bad luck there. Meanwhile though, we got the Germans breaking through here. Kreutz with his rather hard armor formation there. Second E's hit me with support. Sham there need repairs, got another 50 cover on the way there, and Durex needs to get some Jacksons out. Ram there getting slaughtered here in the narrow streets. And a tank coming up, but not reinforced. Armor piercing rifle would be good, but the flank is exposed, and there we go. With no support here due to the fence, I'm pretty sure that anti-tank gun crew is going to get executed. Quickly pull it back though, that Panzer IV. Through smoke. ECX here. Oh dear, KMG really needs to work on his armor preservation. He just wasted a Panzer IV like that, charging head on to two ECX, not pulling back in time. That was definitely an easy kill there for the Sherman gunners, though. Right in front here with the Panzer Guns with Panzer and a Pack 40 here. At least JMG managed that much. Got artillery going down here. Chuck Norris needs to pull back his infantry. Got another Panzer 4 there already to support Reich. Got the EC8s falling back here through the barrage. Durek still not getting any tank destroyers. He needs to get them, in particular now with the Tigreys bearing down upon his troops. That thing's definitely not going to end up well for him. Another office court there wiped out. The armored counterattack here from JMG and Kreutz is definitely catching the guard, although it's again largely Kreutz really doing all the heavy lifting. EC8's also trying to get away from there. They're not having any of that thing. And there we go, it's quickly blitzing in though. Four rat tanks. Sherman im Ziel. Panzergranate laden. And there you go, getting up some good hits there. Rushing forwards. Gun engine damage there, I think. Engine on fire, we got Panzer IV coming in support. Sherman there, driving away, almost fetching two though. And finally getting a Jackson there. And he could easily get a second one, so I've no idea why. Durex is just mass producing them. At least getting the 40th to the front line. I mean, the more Jacksons they can get, the faster, the better. Sherman there needs to get away, by the way. Got lucky, another easy hit moving forwards. Then he's hitting forwards. Brutal armor battle there. Sherman trying to get, we've got a Panzer IV flanking in. And there goes Sherman knocked out. Rather unfortunate battle. There we go, we finally got the Jackson moving up. Panzer IV flanking in. Also blitzing. Good use of aggressive blitz there by them, by the way. Great job there by Kreutz. A lot of people just tend to use it defensively, but not Kreutz. Nine. Nicht Kreutz. Cash is wrecked. Good. And after that, armored raid. There we got Kreutz falling back with his armor for repairs. Meanwhile, we got Durex's infantry. He's actually got some bazookas now there. They're getting polarized here by the Panzers from the Sturmgeschütz. And we got... Oh, I've no idea here what JRMG was thinking. He just moved into Pack 40s without infantry support, at least ensuring sufficient support. Instead, handing them over to the Americans. My God, it really feels like he's been cared by his teammate. Quite a bit, if anything. Second easy hit there on the way for Durex, finally. Bit surprised it was that slow in things, but I will. Almost actually two here, and also for the Stug. Tiger soon fully repaired. Now you got Pack 40, or two available here for the Germans. No, actually looks like one of them actually managed to escape out of all things. And we got more Panzers here waiting for the JMG. If he's going to get more Panzers, though, it's rather going to get a bit depressing. Got another easy hit there, arriving there for Chuck Norris. Send your orders. Bit of lighter action here at the northern outskirts. Grenadiers with Gewehr 43s and a bazooka. Steady up. Armor here. Go second, Jackson ready. The first one needs to be crewed up. rather than there splashed across the ground. Meanwhile, head on assault here. Hammock Smith is there with an MD42 and a Pack 40, though the Pack 40 tactics has been cleared out. He could actually lay down some incendiary rounds here, or white phosphorus, more specifically. Oh, they're building cleared out. I mean, King's not used any white phosphorus at all. That, normally you'd expect that quite used liberally versus the Germans, in particular versus the infantry. You got the AC moving forwards. A bit bold there by Kreutz, a bit bold. Knocking out the cash quite nicely. Although, exposing the rear right there to Jackson's. Ravno moving ahead first in. Risky, risky. We also got the EC-8. There goes shot penetrating the Tiger. No one doing anything with that anti-tank gun. That's a bit of a waste. And he's getting another set of Panzerzex. Come on, JRMG. At least try. Oh, the Pack 40 had not been full reinforced either. Making an easy target there for the Panzer 4. And there you go, secure there as well. And looks like we've got Chuck Norris heading slowly ahead, but quickly encountering serious German system there, anti-tank guns, Tigers, Grenadiers with bazookas and whatnot. Jackson's moving forward! And we actually got rears on two of the bazookas! Good job there! I'd rather feel like it should have been Durics. We've got another two strike going in. Right there, the Grenadiers make the slap mistake of moving ahead. They're getting pummeled there, and now force run through the artillery! But Dieter makes it. Dieter makes it. MD42 putting stoppage to the Panzer Grenadier, at least some of them. Lacking the full resource here. I mean, they could try with the white phosphorus barrels on this, which would negate a lot of it. Also burn out the crews. Captain hanging out in the open. Jackson shooting at the exposed. Tiger rear. And there you go, he actually laid down a white phosphorus barrage. Nasty stuff. There we go. Burning up crews. Ensuring the tanks, by the way, can't shoot either due to the rather noxious poisonous smoke. Stuke, though, covering here. Oh, the Panzer IV actually going north. While the Tiger falls back under a further smoke screen there. Jackson's not well close there to Vetsu's 1. I mean, as soon as they can, though, he should definitely begin using armor piercing rounds every single time in the hopes of knocking out that Tiger rapidly. The American efforts are beginning to bleed out a bit here. JRMG continues to sort of, well, bleed out and not do things too effectively here, but still holding to a part of the map. There we go, Jackson's moving forwards. Armor piercing rounds, Durex, armor piercing rounds. Rival squad, they're wiped out. I have no idea why Durex keeps running around in the open there. There's all those units. Durex needs to get away. So big fun. We've got Grazer flanking in, ultra recklessly. Oh dear, ultra, by the way, you know, hold fire, Jacksons, hold fire. Have them only shoot at armor if possible. I mean, that definitely gave the Germans a few free shots. They've got Veteran 2 on the Sturmgeschütz. Achtung, but then a return shot there from Jackson, and he lost the Veteran Jackson at that, too. Not good. We still got the Tiger Ace, so here, 38 kills. Panzer 4 running here from JRMG. He can actually call in a Tiger tank now. And then he moves the Panzer 4 in rather recklessly. Anyone got a counterattack here with the Panzer Grenadier? Straight into the Vietnam troops. EC-8 they're setting up their Veteran T250 caliber. And they got one unit wiped. You might actually two units wiped there. I mean, come on, JRMG. Fight for Deutschland, not the Amerikanen. I mean, that's just a lot of men killed and a lot of Panzerstreck dropped right there. I mean, that's only going to make things further difficult for other German tank, and they've got a Tiger arriving here for JRMG. Americans are bleeding up their victory points. Panda 4 abandoned too. But I'm surprised no one's picking up all of these bazookas. I mean, there's three Panzerstrecks. I mean, Panzerstrecks, for heaven's sake. Three Panzerstrecks for three units here. I mean, that would be terrible news for the German tanks. Bit of a hit there from the Tiger, though. Fur Armour's assault is quickly bogging down heavily, though. JRMG is now rather crippled. The only thing he can seriously rely on now is the Tiger. Hoyt is also having difficulty getting another Stuke, and he's still got the ace, and he's, well, better at handling. His units are all doing damage to the armies. Chuck did not pull back his reaction troops there, surprisingly. Units there getting plastered. There you go, larger force. We've got the Jacks near firing. Again, armor piercing rounds, Durex. What, even so many people not using armor piercing rounds? I mean, even high ranking people. It's a good ability, make use of it. Heaven's sake. Jackson, number two, knocked out there. Oh, he's got another moving up there right in front of the ace, though. Come on, Durex. Closer to getting that tiger, but at the same time, there's an ace moving in from the other side. Close back to the three, and there we go. Panzer im Ziel kaputt.
We just lost a medium
wrecked. Beyond repair. And that, rather, I think, makes it here for the American efforts. Utterly blown apart. Oh, he's finally getting assault guns. I mean, come on, JMG. Tiger advancing. More units swatting, there we go. It's the Allies surrendered, pulls out the third armored, battered, gets the hell out of Trois-Ponts. Overall there, bit of a close battle at times. The Germans, though, rather persevered, I think partly thanks to Kreutz's efforts, certainly not JMG's again. I really have to say, needs to get his head out of wherever it is, because it's not on the battlefield again. He needs to stop playing according to whatever neat little plan he has in head and plan according to what's happening. It's on the battlefield. I mean, it's the other way around you need to do it. So in that regard, you know, he was definitely weak, and it was definitely Kreutz that had to carry the German effort. I mean, they were actually really close to losing because of JMG, though it rather became down to, again, Chuck Norris was also the one that pulled the Allied effort to a larger extent. The Durex, I mean, also made some larger mistakes. It was rather them, I think, that cost it. Though there was also some larger overall mistakes. Again, for example, the Americans were very slow in preparing for the anti-tank efforts. I mean, it took them quite some time before they could really deal with it. Even the Stuke there had a lot of sort of a nice grace period, even the Panzer IV adding in there, so that was definitely a problem there. Durex also had a nasty tendency of not using cover too much, they're also blobbing up, which overall made it easier for the Germans to punish them. He got a bit trigger there with the Brownings, basically. It was hubris there for Durex. He should also have been quicker to get some reassurance troops with bazookas when he'd actually researched them. I mean, why get the bazooka research if you're not going to use the bazookas? I mean, that was definitely some mistakes there. He could also, I think, make use of the howitzer. I think they could have done a lot there to mess up the Germans as well. But overall, after that, he was just too bloody slow in getting Jacksons out on the field. He should have had them there as soon as possible. Instead, it took quite some time before he had two out on the field. That was definitely large neglect there. That combined with no use of armor piercing rounds whatsoever is definitely not good either. That was definitely also a huge neglect there by Durex. Chuck Norris tried his best, of course, to make up for Durex's mistakes, but at the same time, that rather cost him here on the other hand. And considering what he kept trying to tank attack, he should have had grenades up with smoke or just use the white phosphor smoke there, so that way make it easier. I think he would actually hold that much easier because JMT again was not very good at counter attacking. So again, he just done a bit more there, they could have helped that. But there you go. I hope you enjoyed this fight. I hope you learned something from it. I hope it gave you some ideas, or maybe some ideas what not to do here on the battlefield. If you enjoyed it, consider subscribing, tell your friends, share it with everyone. If not, you know, send in a replay and provide some feedback in the comment section. And if you do send in a replay note, do mark it as his Monday Night fight or not, and in the replay name itself, kindly, specifically. And also consider donating to the Propaganda Cast. There's a link in the channel description. Every little donation does a lot there to keep the Propaganda Cast going forever and ever. So do consider donating. It would be very much appreciated. So thank you all for watching and see you tomorrow. Bye.